Welcome to the show. Today we have a special guest. He doesn't need any introduction other than his name itself, because it's in itself is so heavy. Mr. Fareed Khan, Director and CEO, Profine India. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Karan. It's a pleasure to let you have this show. I hope it will be a good one.
I hope so. I'm looking forward to this one and getting to know a little more about you. So your name, as I said, the intro part, it's so heavy. Do you at times address yourself like, my name is Khan? Does that happen to you because the name itself is so heavy?
Yes, especially after this movie of Shah Rukh Khan, this tagline, my name is Khan, became popular. I have been very fond of my initial also, that is Fareed.
So before I start, what I understand is you're half UPIite and half Bengali. Tell me a little more about that part.
My maternal side is from Calcutta. So my mother is Bengali Muslim. My grandfather was a famous dental surgeon. So he was a renowned personality, as well as my paternal grandfather. He was a Hakim. So he was a Unani doctor. So my grandfather, paternal grandfather, my dada, he used to practice in Calcutta. And this is where the friendship started between my nana and my dada. And finally, it was like, ki bhai, tumhari beti hogi, mera beta hoga. So that is how everything happened. So yes, it's something very, very different in terms of the language and in terms of the culture also.
So, but phir bhi main agar aapse puchunga, you'll call yourself UP ka gunda ya Bengal ka rebellious child?
No, Karan, I would differ. Why I would differ on that is because Bengal has a tradition of, I would say, okay, the whole of India has a tradition of accepting people. But okay, Bengali as a language, it is very sweet. Okay, so Bengali people are very, very welcoming. As far as UPIite is concerned, since recent years, it has become notorious because of the political reasons. Otherwise, UP, Lucknow has been known as a city of Nawabs. Okay, where Urdu has blossomed. Jahan pe tehzeeb hai. Theek hai, toh aajkal gundagardi ke liye shayad mashhoor ho gayi hogi. But the UP, I knew it was always famous for tehzeeb and tamiz. Achhi baat ye hai ki yahan UP mein maine zyada waqt apna kuch guzara nahi. Aur my father, he was working for different organizations, so he was always in the travel. Calcutta has been my birthplace. So wo chhap jo aap mere upar lagana cha rahe hain gunde ka, wo maine upar lagne nahi diya.
What I understand is, as you mentioned, you've traveled a lot. It's a lot to do with, because your father was into government service. But it seems your first steps were also in government service. So, kya daddy ji ne naukri laga di? How did this happen? Tell us a little more about the government job.
No, Karan, actually, this job was purely on merit. It was, my father was nowhere involved. It was none of his decision. It was none of anyone's decision. It was just that after completing my MBA, at that time, there was a lot of craze for public sectors and for government jobs. Okay, and as my father was already there in that particular profession. So it was like following the father's footsteps. And then finally this thing happened wherein the whole thing was a written one and an interview one. So there was no jack or anything like that. So it was purely on merit. And that is what also gave me satisfaction. Ki chalo bhai, kahin aisa hai ki jahan numbers se bhi ghusa ja raha hai, siwai paise ke.
Sure. So, but tell us a little more in terms of what the job was. How was the experience of working, and which organization, in brief, if you can just show a little more light about that part?
NSIC is National Small Industries Corporation. At that time, it was completely under Ministry of Industry. Now you have three different portfolios, MSMEs, micro-industries, and all these things. But at that time, it was purely industry. So my initial years was into portfolios like machinery financing for small industries, raw material assistance for finance for small industries, government purchase for small industries. So initial 2-3 years was into these different departments. And then finally, I landed myself up into the export department, which was for promoting all the products of the small industries in overseas market. So I was primarily handling handicrafts. I was into builder's hardware, and I was into leather items. So these were the three portfolios what was given to me. And because of that, yes, I got a very good opportunity, a very good exposure in seeing the world, in seeing the bureaucratic setup also. So that was a very wonderful experience.
So basically, you traveled the world on taxpayers' money. That would be the right way to put it.
It was a well-deserved trip, and it was a well-deserved outcomes also. So yes, it was a justified portfolio which I personally felt I was handling, because from some perspective, the government tag, lazy hai, sarkari hai, paisa kharch karta hai, all these things. But okay, I never took the due advantage. Otherwise, I would not have been sitting in a private organization.
I'm sure. And at the same time, what you mentioned earlier, 90s was the time when also there was craze, while we had got into the new privatization system, but there was still craze for the government jobs, and it would be rare for people to leave. So something that you did also, though, you left the government job, you got into the private sector, but it also seems your father also got into the private sector at the same time. So it seems you've been following his steps all along.
Honey, again, this is also destiny. My father did MBA, I did MBA. He joined a public sector, I joined a public sector. Then he went abroad for 15 years. And he was in Saudi Arabia. And then I got into this. To be honest, agar main sach bolu, to dono ki majbooriyan jo hain, wo shayad izzat aur paisa tha. Theek hai? Aur ye cheez shayad, unko bhi shayad ye laga, jo cheez maine dekha, aur shayad ki bachpan se bhai, after all, he's my father. Aur shayad wahi cheez maine dekha ki shayad ye izzat to hogi, lekin paisa nahi hoga. Paisa hoga, lekin phir usme आपकी इज्जत नहीं होगी. सो बिकॉज पैसा है, लेकिन वो ब्राइबरी या करप्शन से, टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, टू बी वेरी ब्लंट.
बट एट द सेम टाइम आई वुड नॉट डिनाई, एंड मतलब विल बी राइट टू कॉल योर डैडी सन इन अ गुड वे एंड इन द बेस्ट वे पॉसिबल फॉर श्योर. दो एट द सेम टाइम, बट यू टुक अ बिग गैम्बल ऑल्सो. आई मीन एज आई सेड, द क्वेश्चन ऑफ अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब गेटिंग इन टू द प्राइवेट सेक्टर एट द सेम टाइम, दैट वॉज क्वाइट अ गैम्बल. गैम्बलिंग की आदतें वहीं से शुरू हुई थी क्या?
No, Karan, it was nothing like that. Yes, it was a gamble. It was a gamble. But as far as gambling is concerned, I was into it for a long time. So, thoda bahut sahab wahan se protsahan mila. I got motivated from that particular, I would say, my extracurricular activities. So, lekin ye tha ki, yes, I had a family. I had two daughters at that time. And it was a big gamble. Lekin bas wahi tha ki ek junoon tha. एक 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 कह लीजिए कि दिमाग में एक वायरस था कि नहीं भाई, ये गवर्नमेंट से निकलना है. अब ये गवर्नमेंट बढ़ने नहीं दे रही है, जीने नहीं दे रही है. ब्राइबरी हो नहीं पाएगी, उल्टे सीधे काम उससे हो नहीं पाएंगे. तो चलो भाई, एक नई कश्ती में चलते हैं, देखते हैं कहाँ ले जाती है.
इंटरेस्टिंग. सो लेट्स टॉक मोर, व्हिच इज समथिंग व्हिच वी ऑल नो यू बाय, प्रोफाइन इंडिया. How did Commerling happen to you? Tell us, throw a little more light. How did you land into Commerling? Because very different worlds, even in that also a German company. So share a little more light on that part.
This Commerling happened wherein my colleague, at that time he was my boss. He was based in Singapore and he was looking for somebody in India to take up the operations of Commerling. He said that around 40-50 people, he took the interview and finally he decided for me. So I believe he was looking for more for a person who could gel between India and Germany rather than the experience. Mujhe jo ehsaas hua, because I didn't have any experience of UPVC. I didn't have any experience of this particular segment. So I think, toh maine bola ki you took a very big risk by hiring Farid Khan. But finally it all paid off, and so this is how things happened, from government to private, and now today where I am.
Well, they were looking for Farid Khan. That's the reality and nothing else. The right package, probably. That's the best way to put it. So, yeah. And it could have been better. I don't think there is any doubt in saying you're actually a destiny child, for sure. I mean, the way things have kind of panned out, whatever I've heard till now, does say a lot on those lines. I'd like to touch upon certain things about your experience in profiling. You've handled some of the big hathis in our industry, from Window Magic to Aparna to Torfenster, Dabaria. That could be the biggest achievement, and that could be biggest stress as well. So I can't get into all of them, but share a little more light on that. Let's talk about your marriage with Window Magic, Manish Bansal. Tell us a little more on that.
Yeah, before Manish Bansal, it was his father, Mr. Manjeet Bansal, because at that time Manish was studying in UK. And they had a very small setup in Faridabad. And this is where I got in touch with Mr. Manjeet Bansal. And that was back in 2007. But immediately around May 2008, Mr. Bansal decided to come up with a world-class facility in Manesar, and which he decided to hand over to Manish. So Manish was a very raw businessman. And his father gave me the responsibility to nurture him, to teach him, to guide him in this particular field. And so I took it more as a responsibility. And not with Manish itself, Karana, because see, again, UPVC has been a first generation business. Okay, and I took it as the owners, I took it as my own responsibility that the people who were venturing into this sector, they were basically, the average age was around 30 to 35. Okay, this is the age which I dealt with. So it was more of a responsibility which I saw in these young people, that if they falter or if they take any wrong steps, then maybe at some point of time they might get demotivated. So it was a very tough task handling young people and then guiding them in the proper way. So yes, young people, they have their own tantrums, but yes, they're flexible also, because they're ready to learn, they're ready to experiment things. So I was fortunate enough to work with young people and to learn also from them.
I wish you probably met me long back when I was a lot younger and handled my tantrums as well at some point of time. But only my dad had to deal with all of that. Allopure is a brainchild of Fareed Khan itself. Why Allopure? Why getting into aluminium? UPVC is dhanda nahi aa raha tha, paise nahi ban rahe the, isliye aluminium aana pad raha hai kya?
No, it was not like that, Karan. Actually, if you have noticed that since 4-5 years, a lot of extrusion companies started in India, and they were of different caliber and different techniques, as well as a lot of imports from China and Turkey started to happen. Okay, so UPVC was a very well organized sector, but because of these people who were just simply trading profiles and just selling in India, that was giving a hard time to UPVC as a product. And so it was not that we were increasing our share, but okay, at the same time there was a big market which was pro aluminium, and aluminium was almost, I would say, 90% or 95% was unorganized sector. So I wanted to give something which was an organized thing, and this is where this whole concept of Allopure came in. कि भाई एक 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 इस मार्केट को जिस तरीके से कोमलिंग के साथ हमने किया, लेट्स ट्राई टू गिव इट टू द मार्केट अ ऑर्गेनाइज्ड प्रोडक्ट इन अ ऑर्गेनाइज्ड वे.
Couldn't have agreed more, and because we are doing both aluminium and UPVC, so I understand where you're coming from. And yes, and you're at the right segment at the same time, which probably, and the results are already showing. So I'll tell you something personal experience of mine with you. My first impression, my first memories are of you at Commerling stall in various exhibitions, wearing perfect suits, wearing the right combination of the tie and the pocket square, looking all stylish. I want to know, how much time do you spend at home before you get ready?
In terms of pocket square and in terms of suits, I'm very particular, because that is something which I do on a very, very occasional basis. So when occasion happens, then you have to give a little attention. Otherwise, I'm a very normal jeans kind of a guy. Formal trousers mein believe nahi karta hun main. Main office bhi isi tarike se jata hun main. Theek hai? Aur wahi baat hai ki apne log hain. Aur jahan pe ek mere customers ke saath ek relation ho jata hai, to wahan par bhi main informal attires mein hi hota hun. लेकिन हाँ जब मैं दुनिया के सामने होता हूँ, जब ऐसे मंच पे होता हूँ, ऐसे प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे होता हूँ, तो फिर वही होता है कि भाई फर्स्ट इम्प्रेशन इज द लास्ट इम्प्रेशन।
वेल, मैंने तो आपको कभी किसी प्लेटफॉर्म पे जीन्स और टी शर्ट्स के साथ देखा तो नहीं है, बट यस, आई लीव इट फॉर अदर्स टू फिगर दैट आउट। आई हैव ऑलवेज सीन यू ऑलवेज ड्रेस्ड अप एंड नाइसली ड्रेस्ड अप, एंड या लाइक इट जस्ट लुक्स नाइस। सो या, दैट्स माय फर्स्ट मेमोरी ऑफ यू एज अ
ये शायद आपकी आंखों का कमाल है।
ये भी हो सकता है। सर, how many years actually it's been with Commerling? I forgot to ask you about that part. I actually don't know the exact number there in terms of the years. कितने साल हो गए Commerling में?
Now it's been this is 13 years. 13 years, 13 साल हो गए.
Fabulous. That's long. मतलब रेन आगे संभालने का इरादा है या खुद ही गद्दी पे बैठे रहेंगे?
नहीं, जिस मालिक ने, जिस परमात्मा ने इस गद्दी पे बिठाला है, ठीक है, तो इसका अगर कोई अच्छा उत्तराधिकारी दिख जाएगा उसको, तो वो फरीद खान की जगह ले लेगा। इसमें फरीद खान को ना देने की जरूरत है ना लेने की जरूरत है, क्योंकि फरीद खान ने लेने के दिया कम है, दिया ज्यादा है, ठीक है। तो जिस दिन परमात्मा को लेगा, जिस दिन इस कंपनी को लेगा कि और कोई अच्छा उधार करने वाला आ गया, उस दिन फरीद खान की इनिंग खत्म हो जाएगी।
Well, it's going to be difficult to fill those shoes for anyone anyway. They seem to be very big right now for anyone to fit into and walk into those. Forget about running at all. Tell us a little more about your involvement with UDMA and what's your contribution? How are you contributing in UDMA as individually or as head of one of the biggest profiles?
UDMA again has been an organization which has long been active. But okay, it was not able to come up to the level or do justice to this UPVC fraternity. And now I have noticed that since 5-6 years, it has gained momentum. It has got a lot of members. And this is where these UDMA chairpersons during those times 5-6 years back, they wanted me to come on board. And I said to them, "Look, I don't have time because I have been spending more time on Commerling. So we just need your guidance." और हमें जो है, जो भी एक्सपीरियंस है वो हमें चाहिए इसको आगे बढ़ाने में। तो इस तरीके से आई गॉट इनटू UDMA एंड यस, इट गिव्स मी इमेंस प्राइड फीलिंग्स वर्किंग विद पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट हार्डवेयर बैकग्राउंड, पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट फैब्रिकेशन बैकग्राउंड, पीपल प्रोफाइल पीपल। तो यस, रिजल्ट्स आर कमिंग इन, बट यस, लॉट टू बी डन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द डिफरेंट पीपल इन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म।
Sure, and I think UDMA is one of those platforms where efforts have been made to get different minds together at the same time. But it's good to see you spending a little more time now and more involved and guiding, which is exactly why UDMA needs you. Sir, something a little more on the personal front. Let's talk a little more on those lines. You've been in, you know, working space for a very long time. You've seen the world a lot from different perspectives. Has Fareed Khan also gone through a lot of personal changes? Has he had a very life-changing experience, something which he can pinpoint on, something which really transformed him as an individual also?
The life-changing experience happened, that was in 2014, when I decided to go on a pilgrimage for the faith of Muslim. Mecca is the most famous place, like you have Haridwar and you have Tirupati and all these places. So hamare liye Mecca hai, and this is where I venture into this spiritual journey, and that gave me a lot of different perspective to life. Then I decided to take up books. Maine Ved bhi padha, fir maine Bible bhi padha, aur fir maine Quran bhi padha. Finally jo hai, jo essence aur jo crux jo nikal ke aaya ki be human, be good human beings, dena seekho, लेने की जरूरत नहीं है। और मेरा मानना, मैं अपने लोगों को भी मैं कहता चला आया, जो व्हूएवर मेरी फैक्ट्री में, मेरे ऑफिस में, कि देखो पैसे के पीछे मत भागो, पैसा तुम्हारे पीछे भागेगा, तुम अपना काम करते रहो।
ये फिलोसोफिकल पार्ट, ये शब्दों का खेल, बहुत कुछ है जो फरीद खान से सीखने लायक है, क्लियरली। बट आई एम श्योर फरीद खान के लिए भी बहुत सारी चीजें हैं, कई चीजें होंगी जिससे फरीद खान को भी डर लगता है, अदर देन अल्लाह। ऐसा क्या है, व्हाट इज देयर द वन थिंग व्हिच फरीद खान इज स्केर्ड ऑफ लूजिंग?
अपनी इज्जत, मैं अपनी इज्जत को पैरामाउंट रखता हूँ, पैसा वैसा सेकेंडरी है। अगर मेरे मुंह पे कोई मेरे ऊपर एक मेरे किरदार पे, एक मेरे कैरेक्टर पे अगर उंगली भी उठ जाए तो शायद मेरी जिंदगी का जितना ही मैंने कमाया वो सब बराबर हो जाएगा।
There you can see the pride talking in a guy who is an honest guy by the end of it. And just like I said, naam ka dam, ye tabhi aata hai, for sure, guys. Sir, at the same time, I've seen at times on LinkedIn and some of the other platforms wherever I've connected, you like sports, it seems. I see more than other things. There are things when it comes to sports, anything to do in relation to that, there will be some likes, there will be some comments, something or the other. So is that something which is very close to Farid Khan's heart?
Yes, sports has been very close to my heart. Aur matlab ye tha ki matlab during the school days also ki subah nikla aur sham ko aaya, jab chutti hoti thi to I was playing cricket matches. So I represented Delhi League in my college time. And then I was also into badminton. तो ये दो स्पोर्ट्स बहुत करीब थे, लेकिन हॉकी भी खेला, आपका टेनिस भी खेला. So I have never been somebody like a gym or a fitness freak. मैं बिल्कुल नहीं हूँ मैं. तो आज भी मुझसे कोई कहता है कि हाँ भाई वो बैडमिंटन का मैच होने वाला है, ये क्रिकेट का मैच होने वाला है, ठीक है, ओके, बॉडी थोड़ा सा जवाब दे गई है बिकॉज ऑफ एज, लेकिन ये है कि तब भी टाइम निकालता हूँ.
The closest thing to Farid Khan's heart now. धंधे के बारे में बाद में बात करना, पहले लास्ट गेम ऑफ क्रिकेट, लास्ट गेम ऑफ बैडमिंटन, इसके बारे में बात करना, यू प्रोबब्ली विल कम लॉट क्लोजर टू हिम देन यू प्रोबब्ली विल टॉक इफ यू टॉक अबाउट बिजनेस स्ट्रेट अवे. सो अवॉइड दैट, दैट्स प्रोबब्ली वुड बी माय एडवाइस टू ऑल यू गाइस आउट देयर. सर, इन ऑल ऑफ दिस वर्क स्ट्रेस, रीडिंग कुरान, what is one thing which probably is so close to Farid Khan that at times take priority over work?
Jis cheez ne mere 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 kaam se agar upar koi bhi cheez meri rahi to wo mera social life raha, wo mera dusron ko apne mere dost yaar bahut hain, I have lot of friends, lekin saath mein mere 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 bahut sare elderly gentlemen, elderly log the jinki maine bahut seva ki. सोशल लाइफ में मेरी मेरे 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 माँ बाप भी हैं, उनको भी मैंने कोशिश किया कि उनको अपने साथ लेके चलूं इवन आफ्टर मैरिड लाइफ. तो ये चीज़ जो है कभी भी काम के अगर आड़े आई तो इस चीज़ ने कहीं ना कहीं मेरे काम से ऊपर की प्रायोरिटी ले ली.
Couldn't have agreed more. Relationship is all that we're going to take away from when we all leave this planet, and that's something which is at least close to me as well, a lot close to me, and that's one thing which I probably will never want to change about myself as an individual also. Sir, one of the things which I would want to talk about the situation which we all dealing with right now, COVID-19. It's an unprecedented situation. It would be not legitimate to not have interview without talking about that part. Head of such a big company, a person with so much of an experience, how are you motivating people or even at home in terms of the new learnings which are happening, in terms of even talking to your channel partners also or telling them, because there are people like, as I said, the big hathis who've been there or still there, but they are the small ones. There's the cheeties also were there. Sabko kaise leke chala jayega? सबको क्या मोटिवेशन दिया जा रहा है, एंड व्हाट इज द एडवाइस यू वुड गिव आउट टू द एंटायर फ्रेटर्निटी?
यस, इन टर्म्स ऑफ COVID-19, ऑन अ पर्सनल लेवल आई हैव गेन्ड अ लॉट. शायद मैं अपनी जिंदगी भर की जमा पूंजी भी एक तरफ रख दूं, वो शायद 1% भी नहीं होगा जो मैंने इस टाइम पे गेन किया है. और जो जिंदगी पर्सनल लेवल पे, फैमिली लेवल पे जो मेरे हाथ से छूट रही थी, उसने ये टाइम मुझे दिया. और मैंने यहाँ पे अपने बच्चों से बहुत सारी चीज़ें, बातें शेयर भी की कि ऐसे लाइफ बिताना, ऐसे करना, ये करना, वो करना. सो आई शेयर अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स एंड आई ट्राई टू बी अ रियल गुड फादर एंड अ गुड हस्बैंड आल्सो. लेकिन मैंने अपनी वाइफ को मैंने कहा कि जब ये लॉकडाउन खत्म हो जाए तो मुझे एक अवार्ड दे देना, क्योंकि एक दिन भी मैंने ऊंची आवाज में बात नहीं की है, जो नॉर्मली मैं कभी कभार कर भी लेता था. ठीक है, सो दैट हैज बीन, आई वुड से दिस हैज बीन वन ऑफ माय बिगेस्ट अचीवमेंट ऑफ लाइफ ऑल्सो, कि जहां पे मैं बहुत शांत रहा, जहां पे मैं बहुत ज्यादा सोचता रहा, और जहां तक बाहर अपने कोलीग्स की बात है, मेरे चैनल पार्टनर्स की बात है, इनसे भी मैं लगातार मोटिवेट करता रहता हूँ, बातचीत करता रहता हूँ. और ठीक है, बहुत सारी चीजें इन टर्म्स ऑफ मॉनेटरी हमने खोया है. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ इकोनॉमी, यस, देयर आर मेनी थिंग्स व्हिच फरीद खान कैन प्रिज्यूम, व्हिच फरीद खान कैन अज्यूम एज अ नॉर्मल ह्यूमन बीइंग. लेकिन क्या होगा, कैसा होगा, ये वक्त बताएगा. लेकिन जो भी होगा अच्छा होगा, क्योंकि हम जीवित हैं. ठीक है, तो ये सब चीजें हैं जहां पे आपको एक दूसरे के बारे में सोचना पड़ेगा. बिजनेस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से पेमेंट्स लिक्विडिटी विल बी अ बिग चैलेंज. लिक्विडिटी को बहुत ही हमें संभाल के रखना पड़ेगा, लेकिन उसको ये नहीं है कि संदूक में बंद करके रख देना पड़ेगा. ठीक है, इसको भी आपको जहां जहां आपके ऑब्लिगेशंस है, क्योंकि नीचे भी किसी की ऑब्लिगेशंस है. तो द टाइम हैज कम वेयरन वी विल हैव टू, अब तक जो नहीं सोचा था वो ऊपर वाले ने हमें सोचने पर मजबूर कर दिया कि सोचो एक दूसरे के लिए, सोचो इस प्रकृति के लिए, सोचो मैंने ये सब चीजें तुम्हें दी थी.
Monetary things will always be there. They've been there for various reasons in the past also. But there is a lot one has gained and probably one could gain. It's just about having the right perspective on things. So the last question before we let you go. What's the legacy that Fareed Khan would want to leave behind in Commerling when he steps aside, focusing more on chilling with friends, family, spending time with the kids at home? What's the legacy he would want to be remembered by or want to leave behind in Commerling?
See, first of all, I would never like to be remembered as a director or a CEO or somebody who was a Udma office bearer. I would like to be remembered as a good human being. क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं जाने के बाद तारीफ करते हैं. मैं चाहता हूँ, ऐसा नहीं मैं तारीफ का भूखा हूँ मैं, लेकिन मैं चाहता हूँ कि कोई भी मुझसे गलत अल्फाजी ना करे, कोई गलत बात ना करे, ना मैं किसी से करूँ. आज जो खुशी मुझे होती है कि भाई जो लोग बैचलर आए थे, शादी हो गई, बच्चे हो गए, जिनके पास घर नहीं थे उनके घर बन गए, तो ये सैटिस्फैक्शन जो है इट्स नेक्स्ट टू नन. कि जो आदमी अपनी रोजी रोटी की तलाश में निकला था, ऊपर वाले ने इतनी रोजी रोटी उसके हाथ से लिख दी, ये शायद कोई पैसा नहीं दे पाएगा. तो मैं ऐसा चाहता हूँ कि जो ऐसा लेगेसी ले, जो देने में विश्वास करे, लेने में विश्वास नहीं करे. और लेकिन एट द एंड ऑफ द डे हजारों ख्वाहिशें ऐसी कि हर ख्वाहिश पे दम निकले, बहुत निकले मेरे अरमान फिर भी कम निकले. ठीक है, तो अगेन ख्वाहिशें तो बहुत हैं.
That's Fareed Khan at his best, using the words, and that's how I remember, or rather, that's what I keep seeing at times at various platforms of him. Thank you so much, sir, being on the show. It's been lovely having you.
Thank you, Karan. Thank you, Karan. It's a pleasure.
And I hope all of you out there, you got to know a lot about this person, a dynamic person, still young at heart, still wearing, and probably can give run of a buck to all of us when he is there around with his style statements. That's the idea about this show. The idea is to get some of the stalwarts of our industry and let them open up. You all get to see the sides which you've never seen before of these guys. So until next time, till the time we get a new guest with us, share some of their interesting stories. Khuda Hafiz, take care, Alvida, Tata. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Karan. Thank you.